Come on, you're never gonna get the grades to qualify for one of those spots. You're not smart enough, sweetie.
Wait, am I on glue, or did we not get into the same law school, Warner?
Well, yeah, but...
But what? We took the same LSATs, and we're taking the same classes.
I know, but come on, Elle, be serious. You can do something more valuable with your time.
I'm never gonna be good enough for you, am I?
We live in a society where women frequently were and are excluded from heroic roles in media and literature. Although this has been changing over time and heroic roles for women have been steadily increasing, our definitions of what qualifies as heroic hasn't necessarily caught up. Warrior women are beginning to make their presence known in media, but a lot of these women need to embody traditionally male characteristics and narratives in order to be taken seriously as heroes. Although this is a necessary part of including women in media, and gendering roles is its own issue, the lack of heroic figures that embrace traditionally feminine characteristics and roles suggests that we don't see those roles as heroic, and we undervalue feminine narratives. There are exceptions, of course, but portraying heroic female characters with traditionally feminine characteristics like kindness can still cause backlash, especially in certain genres. So, let's talk about Sansa Stark. Take it from here, I'll find my own bravado. Sansa Stark is introduced as the archetypal maiden that young Westerosi women are supposed to aspire to be. She is exceptionally pretty, she is virginal, and she dreams of marrying a prince, having sons, and living happily ever after.
And I'd be queen someday. It's the only thing I ever wanted.
She is the quintessential fairy tale maiden, and her fantasies of a simple and beautiful world are ruthlessly deconstructed within the larger narrative of Game of Thrones. Sansa's prince, Joffrey, is revealed as a psychopath, incapable of redemption via the storied love of a good woman. The fairy tale structure of Sansa's story is subverted, incorporating an element of gritty pseudo-realism that questions the viability of the fairy tale narrative. However, Sansa, as a representation of the maiden, is not subverted. She does not have the tools to become a woman warrior like her sister Arya, and instead must rely on her courtesy and kindness in order to survive the horrific abuse she is subjected to.
Tell me the truth. Do you want an end to this engagement?
I am loyal to King Joffrey, my one true love.
Lady Stark. May survive us yet.
There is an audience tendency to favor Arya and Daenerys as heroic characters and view Sansa as weak in comparison. We don't empathize with Sansa's girlish fantasies in the same way we root for Arya to achieve her dreams of becoming a knight or for Daenerys to reclaim the Iron Throne. However, these fantasies are deconstructed just as Sansa's are. We watch Arya slowly be consumed and corrupted by her quest for revenge, and we watch Dany constantly struggle against her destructive impulses in order to achieve the nuance and understanding required to be queen. Both are deeply flawed characters, and yet we seem to weigh Sansa's superficial beginnings as more unforgivable than actual murder. Why do we hate Sansa Stark so much? Language used in Reddit comments I scrolled through looking for reactions to Sansa Stark all seem to point in the same direction. We hate Sansa Stark because she's too girly. Her gender is frequently mentioned in a negative light, even in comments defending her. The phrase little girl is used with qualifiers like dumbass or naive, and I don't think the focus on gender is intentional, but it is there. It's also worth pointing out that other characters who idealism or naivety has had far more disastrous consequences than Sansa's are considered noble. Just look at Ned Stark, someone who is still considered the moral compass of the show despite the fact his inability to be flexible while navigating the politics of King's Landing ultimately led to thousands of deaths. Kristen Irvison put it well in her article in defense of Sansa Stark as a character. The problem with Sansa Stark is not that she's weak or sniveling or that her more traditionally womanly attributes put her at a disadvantage compared to the other characters. The problem with Sansa Stark is that she bought into a world that was nothing more than an illusion. She was born into a position of privilege that turned out to have a crumbling foundation. The problem with Sansa Stark is that she's just like most of us.
Did they put you on a rack and stretch you until your bones started to pop?
You don't know what it was like. I was a child.
So was I. I would have let them kill me before I betrayed my family.
They told me it was the only way to save father.
And you were stupid enough to believe them.
And so we hate her. The reality is, most of us live entrenched lives, relying on foundations and systems that we've been familiar with since birth, trusting that the institutions will stay strong, hoping that we will never need to start all over.
That's not how the game works. You're not supposed to just blurt out the right answer. You've got to invent a story about where the ship is going and why.
Why should I make up a story when I know the truth?
Because the truth is always either terrible or boring.
Maybe part of the problem is that we don't continue to hate Sansa. Eventually, her horrific abuse wears us down to a kind of pity for her. However, we still don't see her as a strong character, even when she behaves in heroic ways.
Take him away. I'll have him killed tomorrow, the fool.
He is a fool. You're so clever to see it. He'll make a much better fool than a knight. He doesn't deserve the mercy of a quick death.
Did you hear, my lady, Sir Dantes? From this day, you'll be my new fool.
Thank you, Your Grace. And you, my lady, thank you.
In the essay Arya as a Rough Hero, E.M. Dadlez has this to say. Unlike her sister Sansa, who develops a spine only well into the series, Arya does the best she can with the hand she's been dealt. In an essay devoted to examining the complexity of Arya and the nuance of embodying a morally dubious brand of heroism as a rough hero, it's disheartening to see a character equally as complex as Arya dismissed as lacking a spine. It's hard not to see this dismissal of Sansa's strength as a character as a dismissal of women who can't embody masculinity and pick up a sword to defend themselves. Sansa is also compared to Dany in Gresham's essay, Cursed Womb, Bulging Thighs, and Bald Scalp, George R.R. Martin's Grotesque Queen. Gresham argues that Daenerys reflects the more positive attitudes towards femininity of the late Middle Ages and early Renaissance, while Sansa is a negative representation of women in the High Middle Ages. Gresham goes on to explain that Daenerys is an ideal communal leader because, in her most empowered moments, she represents the strongest qualities of both genders, and that her transformation into a more masculine figure illustrates her emergence as the true representative and leader of her people. There's an implication here that femininity is not enough by itself to be a heroic character, and Daenerys needs to embody masculinity as well as femininity. However, Sansa Stark, like Daenerys, eventually comes to represent a communal regeneration of her house when she wins back Winterfell and allows the remaining Starks to reunite and win back their power, positioning Sansa as a communal leader in much the same way Daenerys is, if on a smaller scale. In some ways, this makes Sansa a more revolutionary character than Dany, because she is able to come into power without having to compromise her femininity. Sansa Stark is a feminine hero. She is meant to embody a traditionally feminine point of view in a patriarchal society, and her lack of agency is frequently the result of masculine oppression. Both Arya and Dany can enjoy a certain amount of increased agency by embracing masculine qualities.
Are most girls more interested in the pretty maidens from the songs? John Q, flowers in her hair?
Most girls are idiots.
Sansa cannot, and yet she still survives, learns, and does what is right when she is able to. This marks Sansa's story as separate to other surviving female characters, all of whom have had to adopt masculine traits or narratives in order to thrive. Sansa's existence challenges the assumptions that a girly character who cannot physically fight off her enemies has no significant place in the real world.
And what did you do? Did you come running to the rescue? Did you fight off the Lannisters and save father? You should be on your knees thanking me. We're standing in Winterfell again because of me. You didn't win it back. John didn't win it back. He lost the Battle of the Bastards. The Knights of the Vale won the battle, and they rode north for me. You never would have survived what I survived.
If we as an audience cannot recognize Sansa Stark for the hero she has always been, then perhaps we should consider if our biases are preventing us from seeing her clearly. Having a strong female character on screen who represents femininity instead of subverting it is powerful. It shows us that the annoying, naive little girls of the world can be the hero too.